called The Lights Before Christmas. It's a beautiful, spectacular display of lights throughout all of our zoo grounds. And they come in many different colors and forms. And there is over a million lights. We stopped counting after a million, so that's why we say over a million. Since we have such historical grounds here with large trees and very unique buildings, we really have a nice background to set the lights up. It's over 33 years ago, and the director came to me and said, how would you like to put up lights? And I really had never been to a light show before, but I was much younger since it was so many years ago. And I said, sure, we'll try that. And they had bought like 50,000 lights, some C7s and miniatures. We just kind of figured, okay, we'll just start putting them up, figured out a pathway. And we really got a lot of community support at that time, that very first year. The funny thing is we went out and bought like a dozen extension cords. Will that be enough? No, yeah, sure, that'll be enough. Well, I wasn't near enough. And we ended up making all our own extension cords because we wanted them to be black so they would blend into the background. And what a success that first year was. We started in December and we still had 70,000 people come our very first year, which was really great. Toledo was really ready for it. Now we get over 100,000. We've gotten up to as many as 220,000 people come to the light show. We do it more days now. Well, this year, every day, Santa's gonna be zipping in off the challenge course, I think around 4:30. And then he'll be going over to his shop over in Arctic. That's new this year, yes. It's the new tunnel that's just opening up too.
So we are in the historic WPA tunnel. So it runs basically diagonal across the Anthony Wayne Trail. So it opens up on the north side and on the south side of the Toledo Zoo. It's been really great to kind of hear all the stories. You know, people are so excited about this project. There's so much nostalgia about this. You know, people, every time I talk about this project, they're like, oh, I remember running through there and making animal sounds. Some of the other things is the plate. The plate is making an appearance. So when we were designing this and we have the Collaborative Inc. was the architects on this project, we knew from the very beginning we wanted that plate to be back. So you'll be able to jump on the plate and it'll rattle through all of this. And so, you know, it's been really great to see how interested the public is and how excited they are. It's been about 20 some years. We had installed the pedestrian bridge. Prior to that, we had no ADA accessibility, so everyone used to carry their wagons and wheelchairs, and it was really difficult to get up and down the stairs. So when we added the new pedestrian tunnel and it had the ADA ramps, we thought that would be, you know, better. We closed this. This became a service tunnel. We had a lot of like our fiber lines and everything through here. And then it was kind of we opened it back up because we really wanted to kind of have a second means of egress, just in case anything was to ever happen with the tunnel or the bridge. We had two modes to transverse, you know, across the Anthony Wayne Trail.
It has become such a family tradition that now we are seeing, you know, many generations coming together and coming and seeing their favorite things.